HR, what are they doing? Jitterbugging. But they're all poop. They've been working a swing shift all night. They're tired. I see. So now they're resting. Come on, Buster. Say, Slippy, this here's a friend of mine. Let him sit in. If he's okay, we'll hire him.
I solid will, boss. You're just in time. Get with it, Buster. Grab a chair. We're going to start jumping. Help him out, you cats.
I hope you can cut this stuff, Bud. There's a lot of triple tonguing in this arrangement.
Oh, I think I'll manage. Thank you.
Are you digging this character? He's going to manage. So your boots are laced, Junior. We'll all read, all read, all read.
Give it to me. A one, a two, a Z, a zoo.
The Lydian chromatic concept is not a style of music. It is a concept of music theory designed to help the musician make the best note choices. In the clip I've just shown, Jack Benny thinks he'll be able to play with the swing band, but is completely unaware of the syncopation and swing style of this music, so his solo falls flat on the 1940s audience. The Lydian chromatic concept will help you make more note choices in the music, but whether or not those choices will suit the music is up to the player to decide, and you will still have to be familiar and know the sound and style of the music you are playing. One thing that seems troubling to most people is that Russell's theory is overcomplicated. His ideas about Lydian tonal organisation are the source of much of this complication. To see the extent to which the two are entangled, take Russell's explanation of how to find the parent scale for a plain, unaltered E-flat 7 chord. Over the Roman numerals of the scales of chart A are listed different chord families. For example, over Roman numeral 2 of the Lydian scale are listed 7, 9, 11th and 13th chords. They belong to the same family, the 2-7th chord family of a Lydian chromatic scale. The E-flat chord is found in this family above Roman numeral 2 of the Lydian scale in the right column of chart A. The Lydian scale is therefore the parent scale of the E-flat 7 chord. Place the root of the E-flat 7 chord on Roman numeral 2 and E-flat becomes the second degree of that chord's parent scale. Think down a major and interval. If E-flat is the second degree of the parent scale, D-flat is the first degree. Therefore, D-flat is the tonic root of the E-flat 7 chord's parent scale. This tonic is called the Lydian tonic. For the E-flat 7 chord, D-flat is the Lydian tonic and the parent scale is D-flat Lydian. This is quite a long process to determine that the most ingoing consonant scale for an E-flat 7 chord is the second mode of the D-flat Lydian scale. The equivalence of chords and scales is genuinely useful for improvising musicians, but the Lydian organisation is more abstract. Faced with this situation, jazz musicians made the obvious simplification. Over an E-flat 7 chord, play E-flat mixolydian scale. Russell's theory becomes interesting though when we realise that any of the member scales of the Lydian tonic can stand in for the ordinary Lydian. Once you have determined that the parent scale of an E-flat 7 chord is D-flat Lydian, then it becomes easy to substitute more complicated scales built on the same Lydian tonic. If you wanted to create a more dissonant outgoing sound, you might instead play the second mode of the D-flat Lydian flat 7 scale. The second mode of the D-flat auxiliary augmented blues scale would be more dissonant still. Because the seven principal scales form a spectrum of consonance to dissonance, as Russell frames it, there is a progression of unity from ingoing to outgoing. The concept provides a means of measuring how closely a particular progression or improvisation stays to a particular Lydian tonic. Russell's Lydian tonic system, despite all its seemingly unnecessary complexity, provides a simple solution to the cardinality problem encountered in the Berkeley method. Because all non-diatonic scales have a Lydian scale as their ultimate source, their parent scale, this means we can understand these other scales as alteration of some diatonic collection. In Adam Neely's video entitled Music Theory and White Supremacy, Neely states that you can use Russell's theory to analyse different styles of music, even 18th century European Romantic.
George Russell and Barry Harris developed their systems for jazz improvisers. But since jazz harmony is largely tonal, as well as a lot of European classical music, there is no reason why you couldn't simply adopt their systems to look at the music of Chopin, or Beethoven, or Brahms, or Mahler, or any 19th century European classical composer. It's just that nobody has done that before. And honestly, to me, it just makes a lot more sense to analyze Chopin through the sixth diminished scale than it does through figured bass.
I don't think Adam has ever analyzed anything with the Lydian chromatic concept, or he may have noticed a few problems that arise. Take a look at this short piece of music. What Lydian scale would you say should be played over the G7 chord? You may follow the outline for parent scale I've just shown you from Russell's book and say, ah, that is mode 2 of F Lydian. However, I may come back to you and say, no, the scale is actually G Lydian flat 7. You see, the fact that the Lydian chromatic concept by its very nature invites you to think of other scale choices means that unlike the Berkeley method, which would simply give the answer as G mixolydian, in the example above, the note which would confirm the scale, the fourth, in this case C, is missing, i.e. C would mean F Lydian and C sharp would mean G Lydian flat 7. The choice of scales within the Lydian chromatic concept would mean you have to be more specific in your analysis and in your writing of music. So we now need to make sense of the three problems I have just posed. Number one, the problem of style and what notes to play in a given style. This is strongly linked to number two, the problem of Lydian chromatic concept complexity and how to simplify it. Number three, the problem of analysis and how to specifically state what you mean. I'll start by showing you how to simplify the scales in the concept, which may not go down so well with Russell purists, but help those who find it difficult to use it in a practical sense. The first thing to do is number all the scales, like so. The Lydian diatonic scale becomes scale 0. The Lydian augmented scale becomes scale 1, the Lydian diminished scale becomes scale 2, the Lydian flat 7th becomes scale 3. The next three scales, auxiliary augmented, auxiliary diminished and auxiliary diminished blues, are all symmetrical scales and are not mode generating. Also, these scales have tonics that are the same as the more familiar names we know these scales as. So we replace Russell's name with the more familiar names and we get the following. The Lydian auxiliary augmented becomes scale number 4, whole tone. The auxiliary diminished becomes scale number 5, whole half diminished. the auxiliary diminished blues become scale number 6, half whole diminished. We can see now that by replacing names of these three scales makes them easier to visualise, yet has not altered their tonal gravity, they still hold strong in Russell's theory. The note collections of the four horizontal scales of the Lydian chromatic concept, the major scale, major flat 7th and major augmented 5th, are represented by the other Lydian scales. Major equals mode 5 of Lydian diatonic. Major flat 7 equals mode 2 of Lydian diatonic. The major augmented 5th scale is seen as a major scale with an additional sharp 5, which we can usually understand as a chromatic passing note. Because these scales really don't contribute to the Lydian chromatic concept, we will reject them in our revised concept. The blues scale, though, does appear in jazz quite frequently, and so merits a place, scale number 8. Okay, so this is the scales written out. These are the reason why I've called this first one 0, this first scale, the Lydian diatonic, which you'll see in the next one we talk about analysis. You might have noticed something if you've actually been looking at these scales. Let me just show you how they differ from the diatonic. So the Lydian diatonic, which would be F, G, hold on, F, G, A, B, C, D, D, E. Right, the Lydian augmented is basically the same scale, F, G, A, B, C, D, E, but we've got a sharp 5, so we've got that C sharp in instead. This one, the Lydian diminished, is basically, again, same as the diatonic, which we'll just write down, F, G, A, B, C, D, E, and that has a flat 3rd. So you can see there's just one note difference between those two scales and that. What about the flat 7? F, G, A, B, C, D, E flat. Again, one note difference. So you can see that between these scales, that scale and that scale, that scale and that scale, that scale and that scale, you've only got a little difference. I put LD. Little difference. Put it there. Little difference. Little difference. Little difference. Little difference. There's not much between those. When we get to whole tone scale, again, it's not that bad. I'll just write it down from F. F. G. A. B. C sharp. E flat. So it looked like that. As you can see, we've got two notes that are different, C sharp and E flat, which are different to the diatonic, Lydian diatonic scale. But it is a little bit further out, but you know, you'd probably say if they're little diminished, you'd say that was a bit more. How would you say? So you say you get that, give that half difference, that'd be like one difference because you've got two. But when you get to diminished scale, it goes out a bit further, doesn't it? Let me just write that down. Just compare this to the diatonic. You've got F, G, A flat, B flat, B, C sharp, D, E. See, that's more out than those. These scales here, see these scales here, they're only one note difference, but now we've got like 1, 2, 3 notes difference, and we've got more notes in the scale. We've got 8 notes. Do you know what I mean? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 before we go back to F again. You know what I mean? So it's, and also this scale and this scale are both dissymmetrical, aren't they? So this scale, let me just write this half diminished scale down. So this would be F, G flat, A flat, A, B, C, D, E flat. So you can see that basically these two scales here, they don't actually, in fact all these three scales, the whole tone, half diminished and that, they basically don't produce modes, because if you start at that, it's just a whole tone scale from G, isn't it? If you start at A, it's a whole tone scale from A. It's staying with this half diminished. If you start at F, you've got a whole half diminished. But if you start at G here as a mode, you're getting this half whole diminished. You know what I mean? So you've got to look at that and say, well, you know, they're not mode generating these scales, you know. So it's a bit silly having lots of modes down like he's got in the, you know, in the Lydian chromatic concept. This blues scale, the thing about blues scale is he's actually just put blues scale and he's wrote it down his own way, which is this. It goes F, G flat, A flat, A, B, C, D, E flat. It's funny, isn't it? That's supposed to be more outgoing, but you know what I mean? Like, these are just as outgoing, you know. So, this, remember the blue scale he sees as horizontal, so like the fourth is natural. I don't know how you get some F, G, A, B. Yeah, you've got B, so you can make that a vertical scale, I suppose. But blues scale is kind of like something separate anyway, and it's, you know. But the thing is, this, what I'm trying to say is, this is his version of the blues scale. Now, you get pentatonic blues scales, don't you, which is just five notes, and, you know, you get different blues scales. So, and with blues, it's just, if you're going to play blues, just play your own blues, you know. That makes it even more simple, that you don't have to play his blues, but you can have a look at his blues and see what he's doing. So really, all these blues scale added, that you can virtually get all the sounds in music with these scales. But like I said, there's a big difference when you get to these diminished scales. It doesn't go, this line here is not even. It's not even, because when you get to whole tone scale, there's a big difference between that and that. If I can write it in, that work. Pen don't seem to want to work. There's a big difference between that and that, right, to the diminished, right? Those three are quite out compared to those top ones. So it's not even. It doesn't go even. Another thing is that it's not cyclic, this. You know, you've got the cyclic keys and the all, you know what I mean? And you start off as, if you've got your cyclic keys and you start off as C. Basically, what I'm trying to say is this pen's not working there. I've just thought I've gone out of this thing. If you've got the cyclical keys, you start there at C, and you go right round the cyclical keys, don't you? And you come back, you end up at C. Well, that doesn't happen here. You get to blue scale. If you carry on going, you're not going to end up back at living scale. These are just making the music more complicated as you go down, you know what I mean? Okay, so I'm just saying that. I thought I'd just mention that about the fact that the Lydian scales, these Lydian scales here, these first three before you get to the whole tone scale, are quite, there's not a lot of difference between them. It's kind of one note from the Lydian diatonic. But when you get to whole tone, half tone, and half whole diminished, right, and blues, they get more complicated, especially when you get to diminished scale. There's a big difference between diminished and whole tone, isn't there? That really sounds out compared to a whole tone scale. So you've got to watch out for that. You know what I mean? You might think, oh, I'll just go a little bit more, and then you end up going far too much. So actually consider that, okay? So let's have a look. What I'm going to talk about next is, oh yeah, making a table to put your own kind of chords in. Let me show you. Okay, so this is what we end up with. We end up with a table that looks like this. These are the scales I've just been showing you, the diatonic, Lydian chromatic. So this has been scale 0, scale 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, right? Obviously with the new names in, I've just put the notes there so you can see the difference between the notes. And here we've got the different modes. So this is mode 1, mode 2, mode 3. So this is all diatonic modes. Right. If you noticed, we've got rid of the mode 3 and mode 5 because they're too much like horizontal scales, basically. We don't want to play in horizontal, we're playing Lydian. So they have gone. Basically, I'll go through this next week, start filling it in, and basically show you that it's up to you to fill this in as you want from chart A, basically what kind of music you're playing. You know, this is the style thing. Okay, and then next time we will be looking at analysis as well. Scene analysis. So basically, go to Bebop Review Facebook page and print this out ready for next time. Okay, so I'll see you then. Bye.